I mean, this is one of the first instances since the ongoing pandemic that I played for a group of people. So that was a little nerve-wracking, but it was very refreshing.
I know how you feel. Okay, so in listening to you, just from hearing a little bit of this time today, I have maybe some thoughts and maybe we can play around with sound. You project beautifully. What are your thoughts as far as sound and texture and what are you thinking about the audience?
I'm sorry. Can you hear that?
Yeah, it is. It's beautiful projection. There's, with this piece, there's so much beauty, there's so much romanticism, there's so much sort of searching and creativity and beautiful harmonies. And so achieving that as the soul of violin part, I think is a really interesting task. And so I was curious, you have the highest part, and he has it marked as an up-o.
Yeah.
And then everyone always, everyone does this down-o. What does the up-o sound like? Can you hear it? Sharp.
sustained chord.
There's a chord. And so that chord. then you...
Thank you. very comfortable up there.
Yes.
Thank you.
that's the note. So the note, if you're already here, then the G sharp has a room. So say.
Thank you.
So, and it says, oh, okay. so kind of surprising for the listener, but if we sort of play through them,
thank you.
very beautiful. Do you have any questions?
Is there, so I've been using vibrato to bring out the tenuto notes more. Is there maybe like bow speed or something else that would really make them pop out?
Thank you. I think it sounded amazing, but I think it was very metronomic, almost impressively metronomic. And I would have loved to hear a little bit more freedom.
Ooh, ooh.
Okay.
Anybody else? What do we think about similar to what we think about Tchaikovsky? Right. And so what generally happens with ballet? There's physically a lift. And that's the beautiful thing, is that if you almost take flight, and there's, I mean, the flying, like all of those things, that's what the bow needs.
Yeah.
And so it's as if, I think at the moment the concept is sound, mm-hmm. but we have to describe the up, down. And so, and he has it for us everywhere, apart from the little opening. Just all singing and preparing for that, and so that the rest is part of the phrase, part of the expression, and then when we have it a second time, it's even more sort of joyous. So let's work that out. Just the end. Shape is kind of.
full division. Now, if I cross over middle and the A hasn't happened, then suddenly I'm thinking, oh my goodness, do I have enough? Right. So sing.
Because you seem to do it much lower than I did.
Right. And with espressivo, I kind of want a choice there. And it's a tied figure. Let's add some.
up of it here. So.
Great.